Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to our hadith session. Bismillahi walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah amma ba'd. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم باب ما جاء في كراهية الاحتباء والإمام يخطب. This topic is about disliking the احتباء or الحبوة while الإمام is giving khutbah, while الإمام is in the khutbah. So hadith comes from, as we can see, عن سهل بن معاذ عن أبيه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نهى عن الحبوة يوم الجمعة والإمام يخطب. سهل بن معاذ رضي الله تعالى عنه narrates this hadith from his father. He says that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم forbade the حبوة while Imam is delivering the khutbah, Imam is giving khutbah. Prophet ﷺ forbade the habwa in the day of Jum'ah. So now we need to know what is habwa or what is ihtiba. In the title, the word ihtiba has been mentioned in the hadith. The habwa word has been mentioned, al-habwa. So al-habwa means you, while you're sitting on the ground, you're lifting your both knees up and folding your arms around the knees. So you're sitting on your back, on your bottom, while your knees up. Yeah, so your legs are not on the ground. Your legs are standing on your feet, and you're holding the knees with your arms. So this sort of sitting is called habwa. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbade this habwa. Okay, so let's see what else in this hadith. It says, وَقَدْ كَرِهَ قَوْمٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ الْحَبْوَ يَوْمَ الْجُمْعَةِ. And lots of scholars have disliked this habwa in the day of Jum'ah while Imam is giving khutbah. وَرَخَّصَ فِي ذَلِكَ بَعْضُهُمْ. And some scholars have allowed it. The habwa is fine. And from those, the Abdullah ibn Umar, the son of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he allowed it, he said it's fine. وغيره, and some other sahaba from his time. يقول أحمد وإسحاق, Imam Ahmed and Imam Ishaq, they say, لا يرايان بأسا بالحبوة, they can't see any issue with the habwa while Imam is giving khutbah. So Imam giving khutbah, if somebody sits in the habwa style, it's fine, but majority of the scholars, they disliked it because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam disliked it. So basically, we shouldn't sit like this. We should try in the sunnah way. Yeah, that's it. So we should follow this and sit in the sunnah way in the khutbah time, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Okay, let's look into one more hadith. Babu ma ja'a fi karahiyati rafi'i al-aidi ala al-minbar. This topic is about, it says, being disliked to raise the hands on the minbar. So raising hands for whatever reason on the minbar. So when can you raise the hands and when can you not raise the hands? So for whatever reason, let's see the hadith. Hadith comes from Bishr ibn Marwan. Okay, so it says, قال سمعت عما عمارة عمارة ابن رويبة الثقفي وبشر ابن مروان رضي الله عنه يخطب فرفع يديه في الدعاء فقال عمارة قبحك الله قبح الله هاتين اليديتين قسيرتين. So Bishr ibn Marwan, Bishr is a tabi'i, Marwan is a sahabi. So Bishr was giving khutbah, and this is Umara. He was in the khutbah and he While Bishr was giving khutbah, at the end of khutbah, when he's making dua, he was lifting hand in the dua. So he says, فَرَفَعَ يَدَيْهِ فِي الدُّعَى. He was lifting hand in the dua. فَقَالَ عُمَارَةُ. Umara said, قَبَّحَ اللَّهُ هَاتَيْنِ الْيُدَيَّتَيْنِ الْقُسَيَّرَتَيْنِ. Which means, may Allah disgrace these two insignificant hands, or these two little short hands. May Allah destroy these two little short hands. Why? Why did Umara say this while Bishr giving khutbah? Yeah. So now the reason is, he says, لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَمَا يَزِيدُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَقُولُ هَكَذَا وَأَشَرَ هُشَيْمٌ بِسَبَّابَ. He says, I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam not lifting hand in the dua. So he used to make dua, he never lifted hand. Yes, only if he needed to say something, he used to raise his finger, show his finger, or this show his index finger when he's talking. That's all. So he never used to lift hand in the khutbah for any reason. So that shows from this hadith that it is disliked by these scholars. So anything extra basically shouldn't be done in the khutbah. So here, Bishr, even though he's a son of Sahabi, he's an imam, he's giving khutbah in the masjid, but he done something what Prophet ﷺ haven't done. So another tabi'i, he stopped him, or another Sahabi, he stopped him and said, don't do like this. So from here we learn that in the khutbah, and while there is the dua going on, we shouldn't lift hand. So there are times to lift hand and there are times not to lift hand. So in the khutbah time, the dua, Prophet didn't lift hand, Sahaba didn't lift hand, so we don't lift hand. But we can say Ameen in our hearts, in our minds. This much is fine. So we'll stop our topic here, inshallah, today. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah Ta'ala give us the true understanding of Sunnah, true understanding of teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and may Allah keep us steadfast on His deen. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.